I'm building a custom turbo manifold to mount a Mitsubishi TDO4 onto a Toyota 1NZ engine using Schedule 10 stainless T's and bends and stainless flanges purchased on eBay. Using a spare engine, I started out by putting the flange onto the engine and checking the alignment of the ports. I labeled the closest matching side as out. Notice the flange came from eBay, not flat. So I place this flange into a press, and then make sure when you're working with a press that you put on some safety glasses, and using the press, flatten out the flange as close as possible for a starting point of a good manifold. Here the flange goes back onto the spare test engine and the flange feels flat. Now I'm going to mark the flange to check the alignment of the holes in the flange against the ports. I want to make sure there's no mismatch which could cause an airflow restriction. So I mark the back of the flange using a magic marker, and then with a hooked scribe tool I'm going to scribe where the port meets with the manifold flange. Here's a close-up of the scribe marks. Next thing I'm going to do is use a safety glasses, ear protection, a high-speed die grinder with a stone that's designed for cutting cast iron, and I'm going to match the flange to the ports on the head. As you can see, the ports are now matched. Next, I'm going to work on cutting the Schedule 10 stainless T's and bends to fit properly to build this manifold. Again, safety glasses, ear protection. Using a high-speed cutoff wheel, lightly mark around the tubing, and then after you've established a light mark, you can cut more aggressively all the way through the bend. Using the die grinder, I can clean up the inside of these bends to reduce any airflow restriction. Test fitting the bends on the bench, getting a rough idea of where the cuts need to be made. These are bump stops from the back of a 91 Honda Civic, and they fit real nicely into these tubes to hold them in place so that I can mock it up prior to welding and check the fitment of all of the bends. You'll notice I've marked the bends A and B as they fit together so that I know which direction each bend and T sits on the manifold. I took this manifold to a professional TIG welder who welds on stainless steel every day and knows how to do it properly. This is money well spent. I can weld, but I took it to someone who's an absolute expert and does it every day. And so this guy did a beautiful job of welding up the manifold. Once he's got this completed, we're going to take the manifold and we're going to preheat it using a giant weed burner propane torch, and we just want to normalize the manifold to stabilize everything, then let it cool. Next we're going to put it into a Bridgeport mill and make sure that the flange is now truly flat. The next step is using a machinist's stone. We're going to machine each flange perfectly, and here you see the finished manifold ready to go on the engine.